Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how we can replicate these paid for PandaDoc workflows or automations using Zapier instead. So in PandaDoc, when you've signed up, if you haven't seen my last couple of videos about PandaDoc, feel free to check them out. It has a really good integration with HubSpot, but one of the downsides is that if you want to use some of these automations, you've got to upgrade from the business to the enterprise, because the business automations only include internal PandaDoc style automations. And if you want to have any external automation, like for example, you want to be able to turn this one on here and update the deal properties in HubSpot when the PandaDoc status changes, then this is a paid add-on and you basically got to upgrade to enterprise to use this. So with a little bit of work, and if you already have a Zapier subscription, you can do this for no extra cost. And so it's really up to you what you prefer in terms of what you want to spend on here. So let's imagine we want to change this so that whenever we have a deal. So yesterday in the video, I created this or have this deal stargazer. We created the PandaDoc for this deal that looks like this. Very nice template from PandaDoc. And then this deal was sent out and it has been confirmed, completed, finalized, and signed. And so what I want to do is then change the stage for this deal from decision maker brought in to closed one, because it should automatically update that, right? So in order to do that, if we don't want to upgrade to enterprise and get this add-on, then we need to do it with Zapier instead. So let's jump into Zapier. And here we can start by typing in the workflow that we have in mind. So we want to say that PandaDoc document is completed, then update deal status to... Cool, so we have that like that. Let's click try this. First thing, we need to connect up our PandaDoc. This is an old one I'm not using anymore. We're gonna add a new one instead. We've got the logged in PandaDoc we've already logged into. Click authorize. Okay, cool. Now it looks like it's worked. The name's wrong, but anyway, we'll fix that. Here we go. And we'll call this team, get rid of all this. Like that, anyway, okay. So now we've got that connection, we can click continue. The source, we're going to use the template that we used yesterday, which is this sales proposal template, sample sales proposal, click continue. Now, important to know with Zapier PandaDoc Zaps, that PandaDoc won't pull in all the detail. You can sometimes choose to not have a template in depending on which Zaps you're setting up. But if you don't have a template, it sometimes won't pull in all the specific details for that template in the process, right? It's more like a general workflow. So just keep that in mind. It's good to select template if you can. And if you're having problems, it might be because you haven't selected a template. Let's test this trigger. And we've got our Stargazer one that's just been completed recently. And then now we want to update the deal. So this is where it can be a little bit tricky. Let's try this out. This is our account in HubSpot. Click continue and you'll see what I mean. So we start with the object ID in HubSpot, but what's the object ID? That's the deal ID we've got here. So basically if I adjust the window a little bit here, we can see this code here for the URL is the deal ID that we're looking for. So the problem is though, in this document that we've been sending out, this document doesn't have that deal ID. One solution would be to add the deal ID somewhere in this document. You know, you could put it at the end in a variable. If you were to edit this document, there could be a variable, for example, you know, like the same way we've got company name here, we could have a little one down here with the ID. The other way is to do a search based on the name. The search based on name is a bit dangerous because the name may change the deal name. But like in this case, our deal name is the same name as the document name. So we can do a search instead. So we need to add another step before this object ID step so that we can get the name. You know, if we just type in name here, it's not going to find it because it needs the number, the object ID number. So instead of that, we're going to have to do a search. So we go HubSpot. And let's type in deal. And we want to find a deal. Find deal, continue. The first search property we're going to do use the name, the deal name, that's going to be our property. Let's see if we can find that deal name. Here it is. select, and then we go down and we have the search name here from the pandadoc, just one of those. We can add that in, and now we can click continue, and then we can test that step, and let's hopefully we can find that deal. Cool, so we've got the deal come through and we can see the ID, that's our ID. So now we can drop that in the next step, ID. First we've got to select the pipeline, there we go. And now we can select the deal one stage, closed one. You can also make any other changes here. So you may want to also pull in some other information from the document. At the moment, we can only pull in, well, obviously only the information that's been put into that document to begin with. So for example, we can get the grand total amount and the currency, for example. But if there's other information you want to have back into the deal, then you need to make sure you add it into the template that you're using in Pandadoc as well. So we could, that's a bit more advanced. We could cover that in another session if people have questions about that. But for now, we can do currency, I think. Let's try currency. And we can do the amount, the deal revenue amount. So we can drop that in as the grand total. There it is. Hopefully this will work. Let's try this out. Get rid of that. So if we go back to the deal, we can see we've got the total amount here. So this HubSpot account doesn't have different currencies. It's all in US dollars. So we don't have to change the currency in this zap. So we'll just add in the grand total amount instead. I'll just remove that just in case it causes an error, like so. Okay, now we click continue and we can test the step. Cool, okay, let's have a look. We've got our deal, let's refresh this. Great, so now the amount has updated. The stage also has updated. And if we look at it here, you can see that it's been modified. The most recent modification was with Zapier. So that's great. So the final step here is basically just to publish, and then we can turn this on for future cases. This will only trigger when the Pandadoc is completed, and then it will find the deal and then it will update the deal. And we could also add in another step here to send a notification or something like that if you wanted to have some like internal notification, like for Slack or an internal email or something like that. You could easily create, you know, a channel message just to update everyone about this deal that's being closed, and maybe a link to the deal as well. So anything, you can have all kinds of flexibility by using Zapier in this case, rather than being limited to say Pandadoc automations like this. Some of these would be very smooth and much easier to use than using Zapier. So I guess the drawback of using Zapier is it takes a bit more time to set up, but the pro is you can customize it as well. So I hope this is useful. If this is interesting for you, and if you want to learn more, if there's any other questions you've got, I'd be happy to cover them in a video. So please feel free to share in the comments below, and subscribe, like the video if this is useful for you. There'll be more content like this in the future. Thanks very much for watching. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.